What is going on, guys? It is your boy Garage Gaming here, and today I decided to take out the Abrams for the first time since 1.79 has dropped. So this is straight up the first time I've taken the Abrams out. And surprise, surprise, there are XM1 GMs all over the place. In fact, half the team is made up of the XM1 GM tank. We're up against Germany, because Germany is currently the most spammed tier at high tier right now. And it's pretty simple why this is. On one side, with the US, you have the XM1 GM Premium tank, which is pretty much, when the patch dropped, you would basically have whole teams of these tanks getting their asses handed to them by even the most half-competent player in some kind of Leopard 2 or whatever. The Soviets just aren't even there anymore at this point. But then I had an epiphany, so I thought to myself, you know, initially when the patch dropped, I thought, fuck touching top tier at all. I don't want to go anywhere near that. I would rather just sit pretty at 7-7, have some fun, you know, play around with the Magark with its new ERA, which I have been doing, grind at the M103. And then it sort of occurred to me, when I realised that that massive number of German players at high tier, I just realised that we have Golden Eagles in the game. A lot of these players would have purchased the Leopard 2A4 or the Leopard 2K with Golden Eagles rather than grinding it, because that's what a lot of people did with the M1 Abrams. So my thoughts behind this match were, if there's as many noobs on my team, there'll be a lot of noobs on their team as well, but they're not going to know how to use their Leopard 2s correctly. So I decided that I would take out the Abrams. I have the top shell, I don't have the rangefinder yet, but as you can see from this match, I don't exactly need it most of the time, I have smoke shells set, smoke grenades. I don't have any use for heat FS, HESH, any kind of other shells. To me, you only need APFS DS, because it's just such a devastating round when you perforate it pretty much perforates whatever you shoot at, except for, of course, maybe some parts of, I don't know, difficult tanks at best. Now, when I saw that the French were going to be in this game, I thought for certain that we'd be seeing an AMX-40, but nope, not even close. And the first sort of contacts pop up sort of over here when I realise there's a bit of a clusterfuck of enemy armour, and then I noticed the Leopard 2 there. Obviously didn't go through his turret, just aim a bit lower, because I know that they've got a weak hull. And bingo. So that's the first time I've killed a Leopard 2A4 in War Thunder, and as expected, it was surprisingly easy. So that guy's obviously just sitting pretty, and probably doesn't realise the effective, like, hindsight is 20/20. The guy's got enemies all around him. He's probably freaking the fuck out because he's just been, you know, damaged. But he must realise that you can engage at these long distances with these top tier MBTs. I make myself very hard to engage by, you know, changing direction, trying to move at top speed, things like that. But just in general, I mean, these are very mobile tanks, and it's clear that a lot of these players, they've got that sort of old mindset where you drive around, you stop. And that's the thing. They stop in positions that, to me, are not that effective. Now, literally skimmed the bottom of the track on this shot. Fired again, got his driver and commander. I tried to aim for the ammo for this next round, but it seemed to just miss completely. Didn't go anywhere, probably went short. Aimed a bit higher this time. Engaged. And finally destroyed. Got him through the ammunition. So that one was pretty good. And then I noticed the, what are these things called again? Begleit Panzer. Yeah, so I saw him sitting there. I actually saw him drive to that position before. I was wondering where he was. The Leopard was just a nice cherry on top. So now I've got 3 kills, and then that's when I noticed this gem right here. So we have what appears to be 2 Leopard 2 Ks just sitting pretty much just outside their spawn, engaging Abrams tanks up, pretty much in front of their secondary spawn. And funnily enough, I do not manage to hit a shot here. I've only got the top of his turret, so it's either going to go high, or if I aim too low. And that's when the other Leopard 2K spots me. Now, I saw him. I had him in the corner of my eye the entire time. I knew what he was doing. Once I engaged him, and I'm surprised I actually hit both of these shots. But, you know, I did engage him. He got cold feet and backed off. And again, I decided just purely, you know, what if I just fire another couple of rounds at these guys? And these guys clearly don't know what they're doing. Or if they do, they're pretty desperate. Like, I would move out of the spawn and at least try to get some flanks. Especially, you know, you're in a Leopard 2K. You're fully capable of killing an Abrams. Surprisingly, I actually hit him with that smoke shell. I wanted to just daze them, make sure they didn't get out, didn't get any shots off on me while I went for the capture point. And that's pretty much it. Like, I, you know, performed quite adequately. Like, I pretty much did everything by the book. And surprisingly, it went okay. I thought that you'd have this whole, you know, this whole cadre of... What the hell? Sorry, a notification went off on my PlayStation as I'm recording this. But yeah, no, I thought that all the Leopard 2s would just be, you know, ridiculously stomping over these allied teams. But then I realised, you know, a lot of these guys would be quite shit themselves. Whereas, you know, if it was just pure XM1s, they probably would get outmoded by the better or more average players on the German teams. But when you're going up against someone like me in the Abrams, where I kind of know what I'm doing, I've played a couple of games in this thing back when top tier was fucking competitive. Like, it was literally just T-64Bs versus my tank. Like, I never really considered the Leopard 2K much of a threat to the Abrams, to be honest, because this thing could do everything the Leopard 2K could, but this thing had armor, the Leopard 2K didn't. So, that's the only takeaway from that. But, yeah, and that's pretty much all that happens this game. I mean, I end up going over and killing a Jeopard, and I'd show that now, and that's pretty much the game. So, yeah, it was a pretty interesting experiment nonetheless, because I did think that I'd just get my ass stomped in, but apparently not. So I might start playing more of these matches, especially at top tier, and see what the gameplay's like, because I might run into a team of really good Leopard 2 A4 players, or maybe a lot of the Leopard 2 players are, you know, complacent, because they're used to the XM1s. They're just like, oh, well, there's nothing really to be afraid of, and then, you know, an actual Abrams appears, it's going to be a different story. So, yeah. Well, I hope you guys have enjoyed. It's been your boy, Gavage Gaming, and, honestly, just keep posted. Look, with my channel, you better just hit the notification bell, because my upload frequency is going to be extremely random, honestly. Like, I just don't have the same set of circumstances that allowed me to pump out that many videos when the dev blogs were coming out. Now, I do have a tank review coming out, though, so that's a good thing, because the T-34 Heavy Tank is something I've had for a long time, and I'm finally going to just finish that video, even though the footage is literally months old, but fuck it. So yeah. Well, have a good one, guys. I'll catch you guys next time. What the fuck is all this?